The Servicio de Criminalística, SECRIM, is the unit of the Guardia Civil in charge of crime scene investigation. Using technical tools and methods, with the aim of defining and proving the evidence that will lead first to the arrest of the offender and eventually to a conviction in a court of law. To this end, its specialists are responsible for drawing up the expert and technical reports requested by both the Judicial Authority and the Guardia Civil units, which may help to clarify the circumstances in which the crime took place. This service is part of the Criminal Investigation Police Department, under the command of a colonel of the Guardia Civil, and is divided into four sections, each headed by a lieutenant colonel. The Identification and Crime Scene section, the Police Technique section, the Forensic Analysis section, and the Support section. Since 1982, the SECRIM has a multidisciplinary central laboratory in Madrid, as well as other smaller laboratories in the different regional and provincial headquarters, many of which have been accredited by the National Accreditation Entity, ENAC, to perform various types of tests, providing added reliability and guarantees to the work carried out by the professionals who are part of these laboratories. The central laboratory is divided into the following departments: chemistry, environment, biology, engineering, handwriting analysis, ballistics and tool marks, crime scene, and identification. All of them are equipped with modern technology to carry out tests that lead to the scientific clarification of crimes. The Guardia Civil officers who form part of these departments have academic qualifications in different scientific fields and a high degree of specialization achieved after completing the specific training plan of each department, which lasts about 2 years. The chemistry department focuses on traditional forensic chemistry testing, analyzing samples of explosives, drugs, fire, gunshot residues, paint, fiber, organic polymers, glass, and other substances that may have been found at a crime scene. At the environment department, they perform environmental forensic tests of different samples: water, waste, soil, sediment, and air. Also, non-human genetic studies are carried out, such as the identification of animal species, toxicological analyses of poisoned bait, polluted water, illegal dumping, etc. are also conducted. The biology department makes genetic analyses of human samples sent by the different units of the Guardia Civil, as well as those received at the request of the courts of justice, in order to investigate and solve crimes and missing persons cases by the genetic identification of these samples. The engineering department studies digital evidence found in crime scenes, which may contain relevant information for the investigation of criminal acts. For this purpose, computer and electronic forensic techniques are applied. The department is divided into four specialized areas: IT, electronics, acoustics, and imaging. The forensic document examination department is responsible for the analysis of handwritten texts and signatures for identification purposes, as well as the forensic examination of documents and banknotes. The department also covers the analysis of typed, reproduced, printed, or forged documents, together with the writing tools or machines used to produce them. This laboratory is not only specialized in the examination of handwritten samples in Latin characters, but it can also analyze texts written in Arabic and Chinese, making it one of the few European laboratories that can cover all these analyses. The Department of Ballistics and Toolmux studies all the elements related to weapons and their ammunition. Cartridges, shells, projectiles, bullets, pellets, etc., as well as the places where criminal acts involving firearms take place. Comparisons between tools and the marks left by them are also made at this department, as well as analyzing footprints, footwear, tires, etc. In addition, detailed studies are also carried out for identifying vehicles used for crime, as well as their parts. At the identification department, individuals are identified by fingerprint matching methods. Face identification and the processing of samples and evidence from police and court investigations. In order to carry out their work, the staff of this department specialize in different disciplines: lophoscopy, forensic anthropology, face identification, identification of corpses and missing persons. This department also includes a DVI team that travels to the site of the disaster in vehicles suitable for transporting the necessary forensic equipment and material, including a laboratory truck with X-ray and dental equipment, etc., to identify victims following DVI protocols. The crime scene department is structured in two technical areas: the visual inspection area and the photograph and computer graphics area. It also has a central visual inspection team, ECIO, that travels anywhere in Spain to provide support to the rest of the territorial and central units. Its main functions are to carry out technical visual inspections of the crime scene reconstruction, and simulation of the criminal act, especially in serious crimes, to shed light on the investigation and find out the perpetrators. In order to achieve the highest standards of quality, leading to objective and reliable conclusions using scientific methods, the SECRIM investigators undergo continuous training, developing new investigation methods and techniques, and applying new technologies to the field of forensic science, all through its R&D&I department, which collaborates with universities and companies in the sector, as well as other national and international institutions. The members of the SECRIM participate in numerous international working groups, especially the European Network of Forensic Science Institutes, being highly recognized by the international forensic scientific community, thanks to the high standards achieved by the quality management system, implemented by its quality management department, in charge of coordinating annual internal and external audits, which allow them to maintain the more than 70 accreditations held by the laboratory.